I've already decided I will not vote to fund the government unless we have passed an impeachment inquiry on Joe Biden. I'm not going to continue to fund the Biden regime's weaponized government. So there should be no funding for Jack Smith's special counsel. And lastly, my red line in the sand has always been, I will not vote to fund a war in Ukraine. We have to have peace.
Tia, you covered Marjorie Taylor Greene for the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. Obviously, she is among the outlier on some of these key issues, but there are a sizable number of Republicans in the House GOP conference who agree with her.
Right, and there are other House Republicans who are making other lines in the sand. We've heard Chip Roy of Texas talk about not wanting to do temporary funding unless it includes something to address immigration at the southern border. Andrew Clyde has said he won't support a continuing resolution unless there's language that would defund some of these Trump prosecutions. So they may not all be saying the same thing, but if there are enough of these hardliners who wants something from Speaker McCarthy, then that still creates these headaches for him to build the coalition he needs to pass funding, again, with not very much time when the House returns next week.
And look, we're talking about the implications. One of those is the so-called vacate the chair, motion to vacate. One member, this is a deal that the Speaker cut back in January to become Speaker, to allow a single member to essentially call for a vote, ousting him from the speakership. Now, that threat has been raised after the debt ceiling deal that was cut. The hardliners backed off of it, but they have kept this out there in the upcoming round of spending. And this is what we reported, Melanie and I reported over the weekend. One GOP lawmaker acknowledged there have been conversations among conservative hardliners about using a motion to vacate, a procedural tool that forces a floor vote to oust the speaker to gain leverage in the funding fight if they feel like McCarthy isn't sticking to his spending promises or gives too much away to Democrats. The question, Elena, is whether these folks on the right will actually move forward with this, or whether they just want that threat out there to get the speaker to agree with them.
Right. Well, the leverage here, and I think that's a key part of that quote, the leverage that they can hold using that, you know, threat of a motion to vacate is something that is very much going to be playing out over the next several weeks. And listen, we know that a lot of Republicans were very angry over how the debt ceiling fight was handled. And they've been saying for months now that they wanted to address a lot of those concerns that they had with the spending fight. And now we're here again, very little time, a very short deadline for Congress to work this out. And I do think you're going to hear a lot of talk about whether they're going to have a vote to vacate the chair. And it's something that McCarthy is going to have to navigate. We'll see if he can do it as well as he did with the debt ceiling, but there are a lot of people here who are very angry about how he's been handling a lot of these key issues, thinking that he's giving in too much to Democrats and to the.
I've already decided I will not vote to fund the government unless we have passed an impeachment inquiry on Joe Biden. I'm not going to continue to fund the Biden regime's weaponized government. So there should be no funding for Jack Smith's special counsel. And lastly, my red line in the sand has always been, I will not vote to fund a war in Ukraine. We have to have peace.
Tia, you covered Marjorie Taylor Greene for the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. Obviously, she is among the outlier on some of these key issues, but there are a sizable number of Republicans in the House GOP conference who agree with her.
Right, and there are other House Republicans who are making other lines in the sand. We've heard Chip Roy of Texas talk about not wanting to do temporary funding unless it includes something to address immigration at the southern border. Andrew Clyde has said he won't support a continuing resolution unless there's language that would defund some of these Trump prosecutions. So they may not all be saying the same thing, but if there are enough of these hardliners who wants something from Speaker McCarthy, then that still creates these headaches for him to build the coalition he needs to pass funding, again, with not very much time when the House returns next week.
And look, we're talking about the implications. One of those is the so-called vacate the chair, motion to vacate. One member, this is a deal that the Speaker cut back in January to become Speaker, to allow a single member to essentially call for a vote, ousting him from the speakership. Now, that threat has been raised after the debt ceiling deal that was cut. The hardliners backed off of it, but they have kept this out there in the upcoming round of spending. And this is what we reported, Melanie and I reported over the weekend. One GOP lawmaker acknowledged there have been conversations among conservative hardliners about using a motion to vacate, a procedural tool that forces a floor vote to oust the speaker to gain leverage in the funding fight if they feel like McCarthy isn't sticking to his spending promises or gives too much away to Democrats. The question, Elena, is whether these folks on the right will actually move forward with this, or whether they just want that threat out there to get the speaker to agree with them.
Right. Well, the leverage here, and I think that's a key part of that quote, the leverage that they can hold using that, you know, threat of a motion to vacate is something that is very much going to be playing out over the next several weeks. And listen, we know that a lot of Republicans were very angry over how the debt ceiling fight was handled. And they've been saying for months now that they wanted to address a lot of those concerns that they had with the spending fight. And now we're here again, very little time, a very short deadline for Congress to work this out. And I do think you're going to hear a lot of talk about whether they're going to have a vote to vacate the chair. And it's something that McCarthy is going to have to navigate. We'll see if he can do it as well as he did with the debt ceiling, but there are a lot of people here who are very angry about how he's been handling a lot of these key issues, thinking that he's giving in too much to Democrats and to the